Okay, now we got the rules out of the way. Let's get here into my computer and let's talk about the parts of an email address and the parts of an actual email. Okay, so let's get right into it. Now, I'm just in Keynote here, but I've made a little, some demos here of what we have that we can talk about. But let's first take a look at an email address. An email address always has these parts to it. You have a name of the account. Now, this might not be the name of the person. It might just be the name of the account. Like I have an account called Badges where I want all my information about badges to go to, things like that. So anyhow, this is the name of the email account. And then you always have to have this little symbol here, which is called an at sign. Okay, it's an at sign or an at symbol. And then you have a server. Usually it's the name of the company or the school. And then at least one dot. You need to have one dot at least, and then something after it, whether it's a .edu for an educational place or .org for an organization or .com for commercial. But there has to be something after that dot, and there might be more than one dot, but at least this is the bare minimum address that you have to have. Okay, so it has to have a name, an at symbol, some type of server name here, and then the dot and something after it. So those are the bare bones minimum. So if we take a look at my address for Badges here on the My Badges website, My Tech Badges website, I have mytechbadges@gmail.com. So you can see I have a name, I have the at symbol, I have a server name, which is Gmail, I have at least one dot, and this is for commercial, so .com. And that's how that works, okay? So that is an email. Now let me warn you something about email addresses. If you get one character wrong, it will not send, okay? It absolutely has to be perfect. Now capitalization does not matter. So if it's a capital B or a small b, doesn't matter, but it has to be a B if that's in the address. You know what I'm saying? So let's go back to my example here. So let's say I did My Tech Badges, but I left out the D. I spelled badges without the D in it. You know, that would not get to me because computers, it's either right or it's wrong, and it has to be right. Now I could have a capital B in there and it would still work. It still sees that as a B and it would, D. What am I doing there? See, that still wouldn't have worked. Mytechbadges.com. That would have still worked, but because it doesn't care about capitalization, but it absolutely has to be spelled correctly. Let me just put the normal D in there so you see what I'm talking about here. So that's kind of the one thing you need to remember. And it's the same as your house address or the address of a store somewhere. Like if I live in apartment 2306 and you send a letter to apartment 2307, you know, that's not going to work, right? It's going to go to my neighbor's apartment, not me. So that's why it absolutely has to be spelled perfectly right. Okay, so when someone gives you their email address, you double check it. All right, now let's take a look at the actual parts of an email. All right, so I took a screen capture here of just my normal email, a blank email, and let's just go over some of these things. We're going to get really good at this over this course. But this is the send button here. It's like a little folded up paper airplane. You have a little drop down menu of some other things you could add to our address area. We have an undo button. The paperclip. Paperclip always stands for attaching something. Like your paperclip's going to hold something else onto this. So you can attach a paperclip and then you can change your fonts and add photos and some emojis and things like this. Okay, so that's kind of covers the top bar there. We have a to. You know, who you want to send the email to. The CC stands for carbon copy. Carbon copy is an old term. We used to copy things by putting two pieces of paper together with a piece of carbon between them, and then whatever you wrote on the top paper was carbon copied to the bottom paper, exactly in your same handwriting. It would happen at the same time. So that's where the term comes from, is a carbon copy. But all that means is that you're going to send an email to this person and the exact same email will go to another person. It's really handy if, say I was, as an adult, I'm asking a teacher permission to come visit their class to talk about badges, I might carbon copy the principal. Now, when you receive a carbon copy, it's just usually just for information, just that you want to know, but you're not really going to reply to it, okay? So that's what that is. As a student, you're rarely going to ever use carbon copying, okay? Then here's the glorious subject line that we've talked about. The subject line has to be something pertinent so that the person receiving it can understand what the subject of the email is going to be. and then your email address. So this is my email address at the school, and that kind of gives you the idea of where it's, I mean, that's my account that I'm using, so I know where it's coming from. And then this big area down here, you're going to hear me refer this to a lot, and this is called the body of the email, okay? The body of the email. So that kind of covers it for this quick little lesson we have. The parts of an email address and the parts of an actual email. There you go. You don't need to memorize anything right now, except that you need to make sure to get email addresses exactly right. Other than that, we're going to go over all these little parts later on as we make emails, lots of different emails back and forth. Okay?